Welcome to City Week, ladies and gentlemen. Today I have the pleasure of sitting down with a lady that is very well known in our community and perhaps needs no introduction, but I'm going to do it anyway. I'm going to say, ladies and gentlemen, I want to welcome Ms. Carol Cain to our show. Carol, welcome to the show
today. Thank you. It's great to be here.
Well, it's a pleasure always to sit down with you, and I just always remember Rosie the Riveter.
I can do that.
You can do that, right? Well, Carol, you're here today to share information about something that's coming up in our community. And I learned today this is the 22nd annual
Azalea Storytelling Festival.
Oh, my. I'm going to start, but tell me a little bit, and I know you're the artistic director for the LSPA. Talk a little bit about your role there, and talk about why this is so important for our community.
Well, I've actually been a member of the Azalea Storytelling Festival Committee since its inception. Uh-huh. And if I can be honest, they asked me to be on the committee to form a festival that I didn't even understand what it was going to be.
Okay.
So I had an introduction to the world of storytelling when I joined this committee, and we had that first festival. And honestly, my eyes were opened, my world was expanded, and even my artistic talents were stirred up because of the Azalea Festival Committee. So along the way, I've taken the title of artistic director for the festival, which means I have the job of helping to pick and contact the tellers that we're bringing in.
Okay.
So on a personal level, my interest in storytelling has grown. I've discovered I might have a gift for it, which is good. I certainly enjoy being a part of our festival and emceeing it and hosting the festival.
Absolutely. And you've been the MC for a number of years.
Well, I don't remember exactly how many. Uh-huh. At least half of them.
Okay. It's
either my 11th or 12th year as the festival MC.
Okay. Yeah, before we came on the air, we were talking about it's so important when you have a program that the MC basically kind of holds the crowd together
and
energizes each one of the presenters. Tell me that little slogan
well,
you said.
Well, I laughed and said when I was learning about storytelling and MCing, Donald Davis gave me this wonderful little expression that I always think about. And it says, the MC should park the cars, not get in them.
Okay.
So that sounds fun. What does that mean?
Uh-huh.
The idea is that my job gathers the energy from the crowd,
right,
but hands it over to the teller and says, here, they're yours.
Take it away.
And I should never be an energy hog. And I should never talk too much, which is challenging for me.
Okay.
But give just enough information about the teller to pique the interest of the audience and get them interested in hearing the teller.
Okay.
And then the other fun part of that for me, which is why I'm here on this show, is that I get to introduce LaGrange to the guests that come to our community for the festival.
Absolutely.
So I get to serve as the hostess, and it's my home. Welcome to my home.
Yes.
And that's as small as Callaway Auditorium and as large as the city of LaGrange and Troup County.
That's right.
So
that's
it's fun for me to play that role.
Well, you know, you've been an ambassador for the community for a very long time, and I think you do a wonderful job.
Thank you.
You know, from Lafayette Rosie the Riveter to MC and all the other hats that you wear here in our community. I know that you do an outstanding job, Carol.
Thank you.
And you're talking about the lineup. Let's talk about the lineup that you have for this year.
Well, we're very excited. Many of the people in our community that already attend the Azalea Festival will recognize some of the names.
Uh-huh.
We're bringing back Michael Reno Harrell. Michael is from North Carolina. He's a singer-songwriter. So his stories are both of the spoken word, but of the sung word as well.
Okay.
So he, as we were discussing, is one of those tellers that you're laughing and you're going along, and then all of a sudden you go, oh, what a point.
Yeah,
you know, it makes a beautiful point. In fact, one of my favorite stories he tells is about his siblings and he cleaning out his parents' house after they were selling the house and having a contest to see who could find the weirdest item.
Oh my.
And it's very funny. I mean, it's poignant. If for any of us that have been in that position of cleaning out a parent's house,
mm-hmm.
we know how hard that can be, but to have brought this humorous spin to it and finding, you know, weird and strange things in your parents' house.
I can only imagine.
Oh, yeah.
I can only imagine.
Kevin Kling is coming back to us. Kevin is from Minnesota and just loves traveling to LaGrange for our festival. And I recently described him as being the perfect blend of wit and heart.
Okay.
He is just hysterically funny, but he gets you in the heart. I mean, he tugs at the heartstrings. He is an author and a playwright.
Okay.
He's done both children's books and adult books. And then just this gifted storyteller that you will fall in love with.
Okay, very good.
We're also bringing back Bill Lepp. And Bill is a five-time West Virginia Liars Contest winner.
He's
a champion liar.
Ed Liar, okay.
And the thing is, he pulls you in little by little. He starts telling a story that sounds like it's totally true, and then the next thing you know, you're going, wait a minute, that didn't happen. That couldn't happen. But you're so caught in it, you don't care.
Okay.
Oh. And then our fourth teller is new-ish to LaGrange. She is Dolores Hydock.
Okay.
She's coming from Birmingham, Alabama. She is not a new storyteller. She's a very well-established storyteller and also actress.
Okay.
She does quite a few one-woman shows. And in fact, she did a show for us in October at Hills and Dales. And she presented a program called In Her Own Fashion. And that was a wonderful one-woman show, about a 90-minute show. But the way a storytelling festival works, you can't really give them 90 minutes.
Right.
So we had her come for that event so she could do that type of programming. But for our festival, she'll do shorter stories and probably more of her personal stories, her adventures and things that have happened.
Absolutely. Now, you're talking about 90 minutes to shorter segments. You know, for the series, you got four storytellers here. About approximately how much time do you give them, or how do you break that?
Well, thank you for asking that. That's part of my job, is to allot their time, but also change up the order so that we can see, hear a different teller at a different time in a session.
Okay.
So we actually are offering six sessions at the Azalea, Friday night, Saturday morning, Saturday afternoon, Saturday night, and then two sacred tellings on Sunday. But you'll hear each teller at all four events.
Okay.
I'm sorry, all six events. You'll hear all four tellers. On the Friday and Saturday programming, they each get about 25 to 28 minutes to use as they like. It may be several short stories or it may be one long story. On Sunday morning, they get about 15 minutes. And those, again, are sacred sessions.
Okay.
And each teller approaches that word sacred in their own way. And so you're not necessarily saying religious stories, but they're stories that appreciate the spirit and the heart of humanity, which is lovely.
Very good.
Those are free.
Yeah,
on Sunday morning, those are free.
And what time is that on Sunday morning now?
Sunday morning, the sessions are at 9:30 and 10:50. And what that allows is you can either go to early church and come and hear the second session, or you can come to the first session of storytelling and then get to church. Or you can do what some of us do and let that be church for the day.
There you go.
And then hope you don't get in trouble.
There you go. There you go. Now, talk about the cost for the weekend series.
Well, you've got a couple of options.
Okay.
If you are in it for the whole thing, my advice is to buy a weekend pass.
All right.
And the weekend pass is $45. And at first you go, what? But then when you break that down to six concerts four nationally known storytellers, you see you're getting a good value.
That's right.
But you can also buy an individual ticket for any of the events.
Okay.
And the prices vary. There's a student price and an adult price.
All right.
So I would encourage everyone to go to the LSPA website, which is lsparts.org. And you can see the ticket prices listed there.
Absolutely. And you know, Carol, we were talking before we came on. You were telling me that the national storytelling started in Jonesboro, Tennessee.
Right.
And it's been going on for 40 years.
Well over 40 years.
Well over 40 years
right.
now. Talk about, and I know that you've been there in the past. So talk about that experience a little bit, if you don't mind.
Well, it's very exciting to go to other festivals. And if you're going to be on a festival committee, you really should do that.
Okay.
And I go to festivals for two reasons. One, I'm going because I love it, and I'm going to hear what other storytellers are doing.
Uh-huh.
But secondly, I'm also going to hear tellers that we might bring to LaGrange.
Okay.
When you go to the National Festival, you're in the mix with 10,000 people. And you have to make choices. It's not like our festival where you hear everybody every time. You get a big schedule and they're like six or seven tents and you have to say, oh, I'm going here to hear him, but I'm going there to hear her next. And you move constantly.
Yeah,
and it's a very hilly community, so you're going up and down hills the whole weekend.
So you get your workout in.
Right, you get a workout in. But what fun to show up to a concert and see somebody in the audience wearing an Azalea storytelling shirt. And one year we showed up and there was Ed Stivender, one of the tellers, on stage with his Azalea t-shirt on. We're like, yes, free advertising. But there are people that recognize me, that they'll say, oh, I know you from the Azalea.
That's right.
And so they come up and greet me like we're old friends. And really, that's one of the lovely things about the storytelling community is people do consider themselves friends. When you hear another person's story,
you connect.
You connect, and you never forget that.
That's right. Absolutely.
And so you could be a stranger to me in reality. I may not know your name, but my story connected to you, and you feel like you know me.
That's right.
And that's the beauty of
That's the beauty of it.
That's the beauty of it.
You know, Carol, and you guys do a wonderful job, and I know that we don't want to leave any of your sponsors out because they help to make this all possible.
Right.
You want to mention and thank
I do want to mention our sponsors and say that an exciting thing is this year they're bringing our two of our guest artists in early to do some events in town. We'll be in the schools, we'll be in churches, we'll be in civic clubs. We've got a free concert at the library. Lots of things happening, and all that is made possible with the help of LSPA, our sponsoring organization, of course, Kimberly Clark, LaGrange College, Nissan of LaGrange, West Georgia Technical College, and the Courtyard Marriott, which is hosting our storytellers this year, which is lovely.
Which is lovely.
Right.
Well, Carol, I know that the people are going to come out once again and support the 22nd Annual Azalea Storytelling Festival, March the 2nd through the 4th. Give them a call or visit lspearts.org. That's right. That's a mouthful, isn't
you
it?
You got it.
And get more ticket information. Carol, I want to thank you for being on the show today.
Thank you.
And definitely, I know that you being the MC, this is going to be the best.
Oh, you're
all
sweet. Thank you.
All right.
Come out.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, stay tuned for more City Week in just a moment.